It has been tested and proven that people tend to read from left to right. So that is why we actually focus and recommend that to put the CTA on the right-hand side, typically. Let's take a look at the example right on the top here, the CTA towards the right, because this example of we have seen in the past video as well, it is on the right. But however, it says that whenever you are on the screen, you tend to go like this. So you have a pattern of creating an F and then from the left to the right. So you go to extreme right, and that is the F pattern, which normally I would say 9 out of 10 people would create. And it is all tested and proven. Now, people read from left to right in an F pattern. That is something. So whenever you have your CTA placed, you will see most of the forms, as soon as you land up on a website, will be placed here somewhere, which would be ideally on the right-hand side. And as soon as you land up onto the homepage of any website, you will see one square type of form, most of them, most of the website, but highly authority websites will have their form on the right. Okay. Second technique here is repeat your CTA above and below the fold. Now, what is above and below the fold? Above the fold is something like this, or any screen what you see. And when you actually land up on any landing page or any web page, before you scroll down, okay? So whatever you see right now, it is above the fold. So you have not done anything, you have not moved your cursor, you have just landed on this particular page. So I have landed on this page, so I can see whatever it is, and it is called above the fold. As soon as I scroll down to the page, I'm scrolling down, I actually am going below the fold. So this is below the fold, this is above the fold. So when you scroll down and on the home page, keep scrolling, when you scroll down, as soon as you scroll down, that becomes the below the fold. Now it says repeat your CTA above and below the fold. Why is that? Because that is what you want, and that is what actually you are highlighting. So in this case, the same case like this, you have a CTA here in this, and when I go a little down and as I'm reading, so that people are not going to come back and say where is the CTA, and they will look out for it. But you need to be giving them the CTA at the wherever possible. So there is a CTA right here on the top, above the fold, and then below the fold right here as well. You can have multiple CTAs just like this. So as I keep going on below, it is actually given me right at the bottom of the page as well. It has given me somewhere in the middle of the page, and then it has given me obviously on the top of the page. So it tends to actually get more hits, because if I had the CTA just right here above the fold, and if I'm going down down the page and I keep scrolling, this is like there's a lot of very lengthy home pages. This is just 3 folds, but imagine if there are 8 to 10 folds, I will not remember that even there is a CTA. Okay, so if I give my CTA everywhere, mostly, on the above the fold, then at the bottom, this is mandatory. I mean, not mandatory, but this is how it works. But somewhere in the middle, if you like, okay, if your homepage is quite long, you can then divide that into 3 or maybe 4. If you have, let's say, 8-fold homepage. Okay, so this is it for this video. I will see you in the next one. Coming up another 2, so stay tuned. Bye for now.